and believed that a dream was possible. Today, you and I, and so many across nations, through television and social media, are witnesses of the manifestation of a man's dream. And I think there are a few lessons that we can learn from this, that dreams still do come to pass. And may I say to everyone hearing the sound of my voice that keep dreaming, keep dreaming, because one of these days your dream will come to pass. And to our brother Eric, thanks for the invitation, and also from Professor Frimpong Manso for letting me be part of this dream. I'll say to brother Eric, dream yet another dream. Amen. Dreams attract jealousy, envy, and hatred. But that must not stop you from dreaming. Because every dream that comes from God is a possibility. Amen. Joseph had a dream and told it to his brothers. And the Bible said they hated him. And then he dreamed yet another dream, and they hated him the more. But he didn't stop him from dreaming. When you dream a dream, you will attract enemies, haters, envy, jealousy. But if the dream is of God, it doesn't matter what comes against you. The dream will always stand, and the dream will win. Please put your hands together and thank God for that. The tradition of the First Sky Group in giving thanks every year, I believe it's a tradition we must all adopt as businessmen and women in whatever field of work we find ourselves in. I don't think this is being done because they have so much wealth or money, they don't know what to do with it, because I know people that have more money than First Sky Group. I know people. And Eric knows people. We serve on a certain board that has some deep pockets people. I was talking to a gentleman. They came to see me for prayers, and they have lost over $50 million. And yet, they will never do anything for anybody. And you will never know they have that kind of money. So what you see happening today, it's not a showmanship. It's an attitude and a statement of gratitude. And please, please understand that we don't give or do the things you see First Sky Group doing because we have. We give because we care. And it's two different things. We are not giving to make sure, but we give because we care. And when God called Abraham, he said, I will bless you so you can be a blessing. Amen. It doesn't matter how blessed you are. If your blessing does not reflect in the life of others, you are not blessed. If your blessing is all about you and your immediate family, as long as God is concerned, you are a disappointment. It is believed that true success and legacy has nothing to do with deep pockets or houses or earthly possessions, but has everything to do with the difference you made in the life of others. And no matter how gifted you are and what you have in this life, if it doesn't make a difference and put a smile on the face and on the life of others, you are not blessed. And it will have a place in eternity and in history, then it has everything to do with making our giftings, our skills, our IQ, our knowledge, and who we are and all that we will ever be, making it available to the benefits of others. God said, Abraham, I will bless you so you can be a blessing. That is the essence of blessing. Being blessed to be a blessing. We don't give thanks every year because we don't know what to do with resources. We don't do this because we are making show. I was talking to somebody the other day and I said, the only thing that overcomes evil in this life is good. The Bible said, overcoming evil with good. And the Bible said, it is good to give thanks. It is good. It's not prideful. It's not arrogance to give thanks. It's not showmanship to give thanks. It is a good thing to give thanks unto the Lord. And if thanksgiving is a good thing, then thanksgiving overcomes good. Please put your hands together. Thank God for the attitude of gratitude. I was looking at Luke, the 17th chapter, from the 12th verse to the 19th verse, and I saw these 10 lepers. The Bible said they stood afar off. Today we are talking about social distance. But this was more than social distance. This is far distance. Because in those days, according to the law of those days, lepers were isolated, separated from society, and were not allowed to come close. And they stood afar off. And when they saw Jesus, the 13th chapter verse, the Bible said, and they cried out with a loud voice and said, Master, have mercy on us. And Jesus immediately responded and said, go, show thyself to the priest. On their way, one among the 10 realized that he was healed. He did not go to show himself to the priest. He said, I didn't need any more arguments. This is enough. Amen. And he turned back and went with a loud voice to give thanks to the Lord. But the 9 were silenced and quiet and went home. Whenever we need something from God, we scream about it. We call for prayer. We shout, we scream, God, help, mercy, help me, grace. And we don't care what we do, how much we scream to get hold of God's attention for help. But when God performs a miracle, when God intervenes, and when God helps us, we become silent. We keep quiet. We go under the radar. And we don't want anyone to hear what God has done. We don't thank him. And even if we do, we do it secretly. We don't want our left hand to see what our right hand is doing. Because to them, if God has done it, so what? It is his responsibility to do it. That is why he's God. But Jesus said, were they not 10 that were healed? Where are the 9? Except this stranger. Jesus said, the only one who came back to say thank you is this stranger. A stranger. A Samaritan. None of us must have a sense of entitlement. none of us are entitled to anything in this life. Ladies and gentlemen, you are not, you and I are not entitled to anything. And therefore, we must understand that giving thanks is a good thing, because thanksgiving guarantees you more. You can't have more if you haven't given thanks for what you have received before. So if we are gathered here today to give thanks, we are not giving thanks as a show, but it is the right thing to do. Giving thanks is a good thing, because thanksgiving guarantees longevity. And thanksgiving is critical for progress for all of us. You know, the Greek philosophers and civilization said that in every country there are three kinds of people. We have people who are very educated, enlightened, achievers, but are selfish, self-centered, inward-looking, desensitized, think about themselves and immediate family alone, don't care about anybody but themselves. They call such people idiots. And those kind of people will never have a place in history. And they'll never be remembered by history, because they live for self and not for the benefit of anyone. That I prefer not to be just a citizen of country, but I choose to be a citizen of a global village, knowing that the world is a global village. A pandemic took place in China in the matters of hours and few days. It swept across the entire universe and brought kingdoms and kings, princes and princesses to their knees and bankrupted nations. And that is to tell you and I that none is saved until all is saved. So it's not enough to be citizen of country, but we must be citizen of nations and of the world, caring for others, looking out for the good of others, interceding for the peace of the countries, of the world, and praying for the peace and the healing of the nations. I want to thank again the CEO of the Sky Group of Company for this good initiative. And I want to say to you that keep dreaming the dreams you dream, because every dream from God is possible, and dreams do come to pass. And I am persuaded that he that has begun a good work in you and in this organization shall be faithful to perform it until the day of Jesus Christ. May I wish you a blessed and a prosperous new year, and may there be no loss of any life here throughout 2021. May everyone here see the goodness of God in the land of the living, and may the Lord grant us all divine escapes from all our fears and from the things that intimidates us. May nothing threaten our life this year, either by air, by land, and by water. But may the Lord preserve all under the sound of my voice and cause you to see his glory this year. In the name of him who laid in the grave and arose triumphant on the third day and ascended above all heavens and is seated on the right hand of the Father, ever make intercession for Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God. Thank you.
So I believe that we are moving from, we are walking out, we are pushing our way into a new thing. Yeah. I also want to thank God that with all what the devil has wanted to do after the elections, sanity has prevailed, and His Excellency, former President, has taken his plea to the court. Being a Democrat and a peace-loving man, and of course the current president and the president-elect, being a Democrat and peace-loving man, they will accept whatever will come out. But let me send a caution to the media and the populace. Let us give the Supreme Court opportunity to do their work. The news commentators who have become lawyers, everybody giving judgment, let us wait and trust our legal luminaries that they will deliver, because they've done it before. Whenever I see people chastising a Supreme Court and a legal system, it really pains me as a head of a church. And let us desist from that. I'll also say that people have been chastising the Peace Council. Archbishop is a member. I took over from Professor Kokunina, and our chairman and the team, they are working tirelessly at the perils of their lives. So if you don't see them issuing statement or talking or making noise, it doesn't mean they are not working. So please bear with them and pray with them. God is doing a new thing for this company, and it will come to pass. But let me say something. When we met as a group and we decided to invite the Archbishop, we knew how busy he is. And coming at the first Sunday, when we talked about Professor Kokunina, there are thousands of Pentecost churches in Ghana and outside. Evangelical Church, under the able leadership of Reverend Apia Wachu, coming. My own General Secretary and Treasurer coming, and Apostle Desnedula and the pastors. A thought came to me. Jesus was on a mission, and he heard that a man has lost a son or a child, and they called him. The child was sick. The man had built a synagogue for the Lord, Luke 7. So he left everything and went there. In 2 Kings, I think, chapter 4, a lady had been kind to Prophet Elisha. The lady lost the son when she went to Elisha, an old man, very, very busy. He could have given 1,001 reasons why he couldn't be there. He could have sent someone. But because of what she has done, this old man walked straight from his place to where the child was lying, lied on him and breathed on him, and the child came to life. We, the clergy here, and the churches have acknowledged the good work that First Car is doing. That is why we have come. To compliment and to support and to motivate him. And we believe that he is going to do more. And we want to thank God for his life. Ministers and senior men, my own father, have come here to support us. I want to say that it is not only in First Guy Group that God wants to do something. But every enterprise, every company that will give God first in whatever they do, that will think about humanity and also give to support mankind, the good Lord will never leave such a company alone. So I want to say that, Eric, keep on keeping on. Go labor on, spend and be spent. With joy, do the master's will, and the good Lord will bless you. And to the staff, whatever you do, do it with all your heart. I know your support, your cooperation, your hard work has brought us that far. Continue to work us unto the Lord, and give your very best to move this group forward. And for the rest of us, the greatest service we can do for First Sky Group is to pray for their CEO and their staff, and that God will continue to bless them and protect them. I'm very grateful for what he has done in the past year. Greater things he is going to do because he's a good God. Thank you for giving me this time to share my thoughts. God bless you.